This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. 229 Wounded VE Southwest Africa Campaign Merits Rebellion Campaign in Angola Battle of Sanfontein Battle of Kakamas Battle of Trekkopis Battle of Otavi VE Scramble for Africa Boer War 1880 Tunisia 1881 Sudan 1881 Egypt 1882 Wasulu 1883 Eritrea 1887 Dahomey 1890 Mashonaland 1890 Dahomey 1892 Matabeleland 1893 Wasulu 1894 Ashanti 1895 Ethiopia 1895 Matabeleland 1896 Zanzibar 1896 Benin 1897 Wasulu 1898 Chad 1898 Kosseri Fashoda 1898 South Africa 1899 Namibia 1904 Tanganyika 1905 Morocco 1905 South Africa 1906 Wadai 1909 Morocco 1911 Morocco 1911 Tripolitania 1911 South Africa 1914 The Merits Rebellion, also known as the Boer Revolt or Five Shilling Rebellion was an armed insurrection which occurred in South Africa in 1914 at the start of World War I, led by Boers who supported the re-establishment of the South African Republic in the Transvaal. Many members of the government were themselves former Boers who had fought with the Merits rebels against the British in the Second Boer War, which had ended 12 years earlier. The rebellion failed, and the ringleaders received heavy fines and terms of imprisonment. Contents 1 led up to the First World War starts 3 the rebellion. 4 aftermath 5 see also 6 notes 7 references 8 further reading lead up at the end of the Second Boer War 12 years earlier, all former Boer combatants had been asked to sign a pledge that they would abide by the peace terms. Some, like Denies Rights, refused and were exiled from South Africa. Over the following decade many returned home, and not all of them signed the pledge upon returning at the end of the Second Boer War. Those Boers who had fought to the end were known as Bitterinders, Bitter Enders. By the time of the rebellion, those who had not taken the pledge and wanted to start a new war had also become known as the Bitter Enders. A German journalist who interviewed the former Boer general J.B.M. Herzog for the Tagliche Rundschau wrote, Herzog believes that the fruit of the three-year struggle by the Boers is that their freedom, in the form of a general South African Republic, will fall into their laps as soon as England is involved in a war with a continental power. Paraphrasing the Irish nationalists, England's misfortune is the Bitter Enders' opportunity. The Bitter Enders and their supporters saw the start of World War I as that opportunity, particularly since England's enemy, Germany, had been their old supporter. The First World War starts. The outbreak of hostilities in Europe in August 1914 had long been anticipated, and the government of the Union of South Africa was well aware of the significance of the common border South Africa shared with the German colony of Southwest Africa. Prime Minister Louis Botha informed London that South Africa could defend itself and that the imperial garrison could depart for France. When the British government asked Botha whether his forces would invade German Southwest Africa, the reply was that they could and would. South African troops were mobilized along the border between the two countries under the command of General Henry Lukin and Lieutenant Colonel Manny Maritz early in September 1914. On the 19th of September 1914, another force occupied the German port of Lüderitz. The rebellion, the Commandant General of the Union Defence Force, Brigadier General Christian Frederick Beyers, was opposed to the South African government's decision to undertake offensive operations. He resigned his commission on 15 September 1914, writing, "It is sad that the war is being waged against the barbarism of the Germans. We have forgiven but not forgotten all the barbarities committed in our own country during the South African War," referring to the atrocities committed during the Boer War. A nominated senator, General Koos de la Rey, who had refused to support the government in Parliament over this issue, associated himself with Beyers. On 15 September they set off together to visit Major J.C.G. Jan Kemp in Potchefstroom, who had a large armory and a force of 2,000 men who had just finished training, many of whom were thought to be sympathetic to the rebels' ideas, although it is not known what the purpose of their visit was. The South African government believed it to be an attempt to instigate a rebellion, as stated in the government blue book on the rebellion. According to General Beyers, it was to discuss plans for the simultaneous resignation of leading army officers as protest against the government's actions, similar to what had happened in Britain 2 years earlier in the Curra incident over the Irish Home Rule Bill. On the way to the meeting, de la Rey's car was fired upon by a policeman at a road bloc set up to look for the Foster gang de la Rey was hit and killed at his funeral. However, many nationalist Afrikaners believed and perpetuated the rumor that it was a government assassination, which added fuel to the fire. Their anger was even further inflamed by Siener van Rensburg and his controversial prophecies. General Maritz, who was head of a commando of Union forces on the border of German Southwest Africa, allied himself with the Germans. He then issued a proclamation on behalf of a provisional government. It stated that the former South African Republic and Orange Free State, as well as the Cape Province and Natal, are proclaimed free from British control and independent, and every white inhabitant of the mentioned areas, of whatever nationality, are hereby called upon to take their weapons in their hands and realize the long-cherished ideal of a free and independent South Africa. It was announced that Generals Beyers, de Wet, Maritz, Kemp and Bezuidenhout were to be the first leaders of this provisional government. Maritz's forces occupied Kamoz in the Upington area. The Lydenburg Commando under General de Wet took possession of the town of Heilbronn, held up a train and captured government stores and ammunition. Some of the prominent citizens of the area joined him, and by the end of the week he had a force of 3,000 men. Beyers also gathered a force in the Magaliesberg. In all, about 12,000 rebels rallied to the cause. The irony was that General Louis Botha had around 32,000 troops to counter the rebels, and of the 32,000 troops, about 20,000 of them were Afrikaners. Citation needed. The government declared martial law on 12 October 1914, and forces loyal to the government under the command of General Louis Botha and Jan Smuts proceeded to destroy the rebellion. General Maritz was defeated on 24 October and took refuge with the Germans. The Beyers commando was attacked and dispersed at Commissioner's Drift on 28 October, after which Beyers joined forces with Kemp, but drowned in the Vaal River on 8 December. General de Wet was captured in Bechuanaland on 1 December 1914, with 52 others on a farm called Waterbury. His remark when captured was, "Thank God it was not an Englishman who captured me after all." His grandson, Dr. Karel de Wet, then Minister of Health, consecrated a monument at this spot on 14 February 1970. General Kemp, having taken his commando across the Kalahari Desert, losing 300 out of 800 men and most of their horses on the 1,100 kilometers month-long trek, joined Maritz in German Southwest Africa, but returned after about a week and surrendered on 4 February 1915. Aftermath. After the Maritz rebellion was suppressed, the South African army continued their operations into German Southwest Africa and conquered it by July 1915. Compared to the fate of the ringleaders of the Easter Rising in Ireland in 1916, the leading Boer rebels got off relatively lightly, with terms of imprisonment of 6 and 7 years and heavy fines. 2 years later they were released from prison. As Louis Botha recognized the value of reconciliation, one notable exception was Jopie Forey, a Union Defence Force officer who had failed to resign his commission before joining the rebellion, who was consequently executed. See also. Jan Smuts and the Old Boers Lilliefontein Massacre also involved Manny Maritz. Notes. Carrot, The First World War, Volume 1, Two Arms, Hugh Strawn, Google Books. Books. Googlecom. Retrieved 23 April 2016. Policy of the Government with Regard to Its Suppression. Orford, 1971. Carrot, My Lou and Strew, by Manny Maritz, 1939. Carrot, On This Day, 12 October 1914. References. Bunting, Brian, 1969, Chapter 1, The Birth of the Nationalist Party, The Rise of the South African Reich. Agter Die Skirms Met Die Rebel, by C. F. MacDonald, 1949. Coenrath Frederick MacDonald's inimitable five-volume account of his adventures on the South African frontier, between 1895 and 1915, has acquired cult status collectively. His account is probably the finest. E. Political History of South Africa. Defunct Polities. Kingdom of Mapungubwe. C. 1075 C. 1220. Dutch Cape Colony. 1652-1806. M. Thethwa Paramountcy. C. 1780-1817. N. Dwandwe Kingdom. C. 1780-1819. Cape Colony. 1795-1910. Zulu Kingdom. 1816-97. Natalia Republic. 1839-43. Natal Colony. 1843-1910. Orange Free State. 1854-1902. South African Republic. 1856-1902. Griqualand East. 1861-79. Griqualand West. 1870-73. Goshen. 1882-83. Stellaland. 1882-85. New Republic. 1884-88. Upingtonia 1885-87, Klein Vrystaat 1886-91, Orange River Colony 1902-10, Transvaal Colony 1902-10, Union of South Africa 1910-61, Transkei 1976-94, Bophuthatswana 1977-94, Venda 1979-94, Siskei 1981-94, Events 1652-1815, Dutch Settlement, French Huguenot Settlement, Khoikhoi Dutch Wars, Kosa Wars, Battle of Muizenberg, Battle of Blauwburg, Anglo-Dutch Treaty of 1814. 1815-1910, Mafeking 1820, Settlers, Great Trek, Boer Republics, Mineral Revolution, Witwatersrand, Gold Rush, South African Wars, South Africa Act 1909-1910-1948, Maritz Rebellion, Rand Rebellion, Great Depression 1946, African Mine Workers Union Strike, Bantustans Apartheid Era 1948, General Election, Apartheid Legislation, Internal Resistance, Colored Vote, Constitutional Crisis, Defiance Campaign, Congress of the People, Freedom Charter, Women's March 1956-1957, Alexandra Bus Boycott, Sharpeville Massacre 1960, Republic Referendum, International Isolation, Academic Boycott, Disinvestment, Sporting Boycott, Olympics, Rugby Union, Rivonia Trial, Tar Baby Option, Durban Moment, Border War, Israeli Alliance, Israel, South Africa Agreement, Soweto Uprising, Weapons of Mass Destruction Project, Coast Constructive Engagement, Church Street Bombing 1983, Constitutional Reform Referendum, Rubicon Speech, Dakar Conference, Third Force, CODESA 1992, Apartheid Referendum, St. James Church Massacre, Bophuthatswana Conflict, Shell House Massacre, Post-Apartheid 1994, General Election, Government of National Unity, Reconstruction and Development Program, Truth and Reconciliation Commission, Arms Deal, Floor Crossing, African Renaissance, Xenophobia, Americana Massacre 2012, Western Cape Farm Workers Strike, Cadlegate 2014, Platinum Strike, Hashtag Roads Must Fall Protests, Hashtag Fees Must Fall Student Protests 2016, Schwein Riots, Political Culture, Afrikaner Calvinism, Boskap Borihot Day of the Vow, Greater South Africa Honorary Whites, ROOI Gavar, Slavery Swart Gavar, Utlander Volkstaat, Defunct Organizations, Civic and Political Organizations, Afrikaner Bond, Afrikaner Broederbond, Afrikaner Party, AITUP, APO AVF, BPC, Black Sash, CDA, CTEG, COD, Congress Alliance, COSG, CP, Dominion Party, DP 1973-1977, DP 1989-2000, DPP, ECC, FA, FD, Genootskap van Recht Afrikaners, GNP Het Volk, HNP, IDASA, IDIPISL, Jugrig, Johannesburg Reform Committee, Labour Party 1910-1958, Labour Party 1969-1994, Liberal Party 1953-1968, NA, NCP, NIC, NLP, NNP, NP, NPP NRP, NUSAS, PFP, Progressive Party, Cape Colony Progressive Party, PRP, Radio Freedom Reform Party, SABP, SADECO, SAIC, SASO, SACO, SAYRCO, South African Party, Cape Colony South African Party 1911-1934, South African Party 1977-1980, TNIP Torch Commando, UFP, United Party, Unionist Party, Volkspartei, Workers' Party, WOSA, Trade Unions and Social Movements, Afrikaner Nationalism, APF, BCM, FOSAT, UICU, MUSA, NEAM, PAWESA, APAWU, UDF, UMKOSI, Wesentaba, Paramilitary and Terrorist Organizations, APLA, ARM, BBB, BORMAG, Greyshirts, MK, Oswebrandwag, Ord, Van Die, Dude, SANF, Histories of Political Parties, African National Congress, Democratic Alliance, Pan-Africanist Congress of Azania. Category Coordinates, 25°43-00-S, 28°14-00-E, 257,167°S, 282,333°E, minus 257,167, 282,333.